Hey everybody, it's Kasia Gage and welcome back. Today I'm going to be doing a tutorial in Photoshop, and that is going to be walking you through how to create a photo mosaic, which is what I did for this layout you see here on the screen. I am going to apologize in advance in case you do hear a few clicks on my keyboard or with my mouse. I do have a temporary setup here in my office as I just moved into my new space, so please bear with me. But let's go ahead and dive in. So like I said, this is going to be in Photoshop. I use Photoshop Creative Cloud. And this right here, what I'm moving my mouse along, this photo is a total of a 12 by 12. So that's what I'm gonna go ahead and get started. So we're gonna do a file new, 12 by 12, 300 pixels per inch, and a transparent background, and this is what it will look like. Now, the one thing that you will need for this is you will need photos, and you will need all of your photos in one folder. It doesn't matter what size your photos are, you just are gonna need them all in one spot, because if there's any size adjustments we need to do, we'll go ahead and do that once they've all been placed. So you can see right here, I have one that's called My Layouts, and it has a bunch of all of my layouts in there. And this is what we're gonna use for this. So the process, it's called automation. I'm sure there are probably other scripts out there, Photoshop actions, you could buy templates, you could even create your own template. But for me, at least, this is what I've found to be the fastest and the most accurate to create any type of photo mosaic. So I hope that you guys will find this valuable as well. So you're gonna go to File, Automate, Contact Sheet 2. Okay, now for your source images, which is what I just showed you here, those are all the images that you're going to be using for this layout. You're gonna wanna make sure you select that, and I already have mine selected, okay? Then you're going to want to make sure your document is sized correctly, which I have 12 by 12, 300 pixels per inch, which is what we created this new document for. And then thumbnails, I'm going to have them place across first. So left to right, top row, and then on and on and on. And 10 rows and 10 columns. I have found that it works best to have the same number of columns as rows. You could play around with this if you wanted, but I have found that proportionally this does work best. And you'll want to make sure that use auto spacing is also checked off. So we're going to hit OK and watch the magic happen. So what this is, it is an automation process. So Photoshop is taking those images right out of that folder. They're also creating a smart object for the size of that. And they're also essentially linking your photo. Well, they are linking your photo to then that size object. So they're doing this all for you. So you could go in and you could create so many, 100 different boxes, right? And then you would have to clip your photo to each box. Or that is what probably templates, if you purchase one of those, you would have to clip your photo to each box. So this is saving you so much time, headache, energy, everything and above. Okay, why you see a second contact sheet here? Because I had more than 100 photos. So I'm just going to click out of that and not save. And this is what, let me zoom out just a little bit. This is what we end up with. Now you can see all these layers here as I'm scrolling down. All of those. These are all of my images. I'm going to turn off this background layer, and now you can see all of these transparent pixels. And I am going to go to Image Trim, so that way it takes care of the transparent pixels. And even though you see ones here, it's not going to trim those. It's just I want to clean up the bottom of this. So there we go. And I'm going to make sure my image size, I'm going to put that back to 12. Okay, so now what we need to do is where you can see, I'll zoom in on some of these, you can see that they are not fitting or not filling this box entirely. Okay, so this is a layer that, or this is this image right here. What you need to do is you need to unlink this. Because if you don't, when you go to resize it, it's not going to keep the proportion. So I'm going to unlink this. I'm holding down my shift key and I'm just resizing. So it's going to fill in that box. You can see here, I can move it over either way, but it's still staying in the parameters of that box. Okay, we'll do the next one right next to it so you see what I'm referring to. We are on that right here where you can see the left, the transparent, that's where your image is, and then that is the shape, okay? That's what it's being linked to. So we're gonna make sure we're on the transparent one. I'm holding down my shift key. And then you can recenter, you can reposition, all of that. This is the only thing I will say that probably takes a little bit longest of these as far as just move enlarging them or tweaking them. Going through from photo to photo, making sure you don't have any transparent pixels. Zooming in on them, so to speak. But once you have all of that done, let me see here. This is what, let me unlink this here. This is what it looks like. And I turned this into a pattern, so that's why you see it even larger. Okay, but hang on here. Let me go back here. So this is where we're at. This is our document. I'm going for the sake of this, rather than enlarging and fixing every single one, I'm just gonna keep moving forward on this, okay? So for all of these, I'm going to pick on the topmost layer, go all the way down to the bottommost layer, and we're just going to merge them. So it's all one, okay? We could move it around if we wanted to. Now from here, I am going to pick this, my photo, and I'm gonna drag it onto here. Maybe if I select the right layer. I'm gonna center it each way, and I'm also going to bring it down below. But beforehand, I will mention this. This, especially why this blended really well. This wasn't any trickery as far as dodging and burning or any other crazy techniques. This is what's called a high key photo. You had a lot of extreme whites. There was a window opposite. I took this in a mirror that was in our living room. And then you had some extreme darks as well. Really dark, you know, dark shadows, the blacks, and then you had the whites, extreme whites. And part of that's also how my settings that I used for taking that photo, and then how I chose to edit that in black and white. So we're going to put the photo underneath the layer of where all our photos are, where this mosaic is. We're going to change this mosaic mode to screen. Now at 100% opacity, you can see this is how it's going to look like. Again, because we had those white areas in the photo, that's why it's not, from here, it's not entirely visible. While it looks cool, I think it could look better, right? Because we still want to be able to pick up some of this photo. So we're going to drop our opacity down to about 60% or so. So that way you can still see some of these layouts here and still see the photo underneath. And that's it. That's how you create a photo mosaic in Photoshop. You just end up making sure you do have all your photos in one place. You're gonna automate and you're gonna go to contact sheet and it's gonna play some. And once you're on your contact sheet, you'll end up resizing all of them. So that way, you'll get rid of all these transparent pixels, you'll merge all your layers, you'll add your photo, and then you want to make sure you change your blend mode to screen. So if you have any questions on this or comments, be sure to leave them down below. And don't forget to hit that subscribe button so that way you can stay tuned and be notified for more tutorials like this. Thanks so much for watching, everybody. I hope you have a great day. Till next time. Ba-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-